then you got the medic group, and I brought them a whole bunch of supplies. Fortunately, they're now getting big enough to keep on site. So,
how's everyone doing today?
Good.
Yeah, right.
Next Saturday's like today.
Next Saturday is going to have 500 times as many people.
Of course.
Yes. Absolutely. We will be gathering a full general meeting next Saturday. So you can just bear with us for a couple minutes. We're trying to get in the sound situation, taken care of. So if y'all can hear me kind of okay right now?
Sure.
Yeah? Cool. Well, my name is Josh. One of all of you, we are all organizers in this movement, and several of us have been coming together over the last several weeks, starting to kind of try to develop some infrastructure so that everyone can partake in to help get our movement of Occupy Richmond off the ground. So I'd like to, has everyone had a chance to get a copy of the proposed agenda for today? Raise your hand if you don't have one, and we've got some people going around with stacks of them, and they'll make sure that we get you one. Sirens are totally drowning me out, okay. Alright, well, we'll go ahead and start until we get the sound off the ground. Up in,
where do you buy it?
Up in New York called Mic Check. Alright, so when someone up front says, Mic Check!
Mic Check!
Mic check.
Awesome.
All right. So the idea behind mic check. Is to ensure for everyone in attendance.
That everyone in attendance can hear.
Awesome. So I would like to propose. The approval of the proposed agenda. Is anyone in opposition to the agenda going around? Make sure everybody has an agenda and then discuss the agenda. Sure. Does everyone have an agenda at this point?
Does everybody?
No.
It starts with note to facilitate a discussion. Don't have that, raise your hand real high if you don't have an agenda. Cool, and this is David. He's handing some of these out. And I guess if not everyone has one now, we'll give you all a couple minutes to go over it. If there's anything you'd like to add to the agenda for today, feel free to bring that forward. Yes, sir.
As many of you know, I've been working with the police on what's legal, what's not legal, and everything. I also adopted the list of do's and don'ts from Houston, as well as just a couple of other little things. I would propose to add to the agenda after the...
They can't hear you. Let's go to the speakers, Mike. Mike, check!
Mike, check!
As I was saying... You guys know I've been working with the police.
Boo.
To make sure we know what's legal and not legal before we go into the movement.
Too many words.
Make sure we know what's legal and not legal before we go into the movement.
I have taken their requests. And made a hybrid with. The list of do's and don'ts from the wonderful Houston Occupy movement. Shorter, okay.
Five or six words.
And I've added the police request to the Houston Occupy do's and don'ts list.
Shorter.
I have taken our local police request. And made a hybrid. With the Houston Occupy movements. List of do's and don'ts. I'm proposing. That before we go into the more volatile section.
Of suggesting locations.
After everybody has had their time to speak. We break off in groups. Look at the copies of this proposed list. Of ideals we should all aspire to. And possibly ratify at that time.
And possibly ratify at that time.
Would anyone have an objection to adding this to the agenda?
Would anyone have an objection to adding this to the agenda?
Over there.
Feel free to come to the mic. Does anyone have the stack list, by the way?
Does anyone have the stack
list? Where's the stack list?
It's right here.
10 groups we'd have
I have an objection to working with the police in doing something that is inherently illegal, like an occupation.
Huh?
Mic check? Oh, okay. I have a problem with doing something, allying with the police in doing something that is inherently illegal. Asking the police what is or is not okay about something that is illegal is dumb. That is my opinion. And I don't think that if you're doing something illegal, you should ask the police how the best way to do something illegal is. They're not going to be your friends on that.
Excuse me.
Yeah, I suppose just real quick before we continue discussion about the police list, we should go over some of the tools of facilitation that we used at the first General Assembly meeting, which was on Thursday. And as you can see, if you look around, a number of people are throwing their fingers up in the air, spirit finger style. You might see some other weird, funny hand gestures. So just to go over them with everyone, real quick for the sake of discussion. This up here, both hands in the air, wiggling your fingers. Everyone agree with me. This is agreeing with whoever's speaking. This ensures that not everyone's clapping over the speaker, but it ensures that people aren't shouting out angrily. It helps keep things kind of orderly and civil amongst each other. You've also got fingers down. This means, in some circles, this means stand aside, or this could also mean disagree. So if you do tend to disagree with what the speaker is saying, you know, fingers waggling in the downward position is a really good way to express that. And then if you have a strong opposition to something, which means, you know, you propose this, or you oppose this vehemently, and you really have something to say that should block this particular piece of information from going through, then you take both your hands into a cross. So just like she's doing right here. I've only got one hand to work with. So everyone agree? Disagree? And I oppose. Cool. Now you wanted to speak to that real quick, sir?
My name is Jay. I just wanted to say that I understand your objection to working with the police, but information is power. And if we are going to be protesting, then we need to know what the parameters are. And as for myself, as a parent, I want to know what will and what will not get me arrested. So for instance, I know that walking on the sidewalk protesting is fine. Blocking streets is not. In Virginia, the state capitol grounds, despite the fact that we are a commonwealth, are not open for, they're considered to be private property to protesters. So things like that, I assume, if I'm correct, is what the liaison with the police are all about. So that will also, if you, you know, personally, I don't really want to get arrested. If you do, if you go out next weekend looking to create a stir, to create a stink, you want to find out what you can do, and you know that will cause a problem. Also, on the flip side of the coin. Thanks.
Okay. Does anyone else have anything they'd like to say briefly in regards to these proposals? Add the discussion of tactics to the agenda in what regard?
I mean, this whole discussion of tactics to add it to the agenda.
I'm sorry, I'm not really sure
we're
what it is
here. We're discussing the agenda. Conference.
Right.
And we were going to decide whether or not we ratified it. I suggested that we add this to the agenda.
Okay.
Not, instead of taking away from people's speaking time,
okay,
before we got to the more divisive issue, and then this other discussion started.
Okay.
And she's asking that she also adds, that we also add the discussion of tactics, such as whether or not we're allowed to liaison with the police, to the agenda as well.
Okay, so there has been a proposal to add, I guess, tactics to the agenda, so if we want to work with the police or not. I think that perhaps just for the sake of getting through these first few talking points of information, we get through those and then we bring it back to ratifying points of information. Is everyone in agreement with that? Beautiful. Okay, so just to review our last session on October 7th, we had maybe 250 people or so show up right over there by the fountain, and it was, I think for those in attendance would agree, a very interesting first meeting. And we came to essentially three basic conclusions as a group through modified consensus as to how we would proceed from there. Number one, we are committed to nonviolent action and change. So we will be peaceful protesters. Is that something pretty agreeable to the group here as well? All right.
We've got a block.
Can y'all come speak to that after we just get through the other two real quick? And then absolutely you can have the floor. Awesome. We've got that. We've got also that we will occupy a location on October 15th, as in October 15th is the day that we will meet. We will do that in Monroe Park at about 4 p.m. on that day, shortly after the Women's Rights Rally. And we will then decide at that time, at this location, where it is that we will go to occupy as Occupy Richmond. And, okay, so we had a block right over here. If you'd like to come to the mic and speak, please feel free.
So I sort of take issue with the idea of like dogmatic nonviolence in general. I think that like nonviolence as a tactical decision is something that should be made on an individual basis. And clearly that if you're going to be engaging in property destruction or defensive violence or whatever, you probably shouldn't be doing it in the presence of those who are clearly either more at risk for arrest and aren't going to be doing it. But having established guidelines for what sort of actions people are going to be doing, I find to be extremely oppressive, and I think that allowing space for a diversity of tactics is really, really important for creating any sort of legitimate movement that has the capacity to actually affect any sort of realistic change.
I have a question. Do you define property destruction as violence?
I absolutely do not define property destruction as violence.
Thank you.
Hello, my name is Mark. I'd like to respond to that. I think that tactics of violence and our approach is very important for those who would like to engage in other tactics. It might tank the whole movement. I think we should always try to accomplish as much as we can and everything. If things come up to a point where someone feel like their rights are being stepped on, that their bodily harm, of course, defend yourself. But we don't want to have the go-ahead notion that we want to kick up dust and we want to create a problem, and then that's what they're going to put in the paper. That's what they're going to label us. Thank you.
Can I make a really quick direct response based on personal
experience? Sure.
I'm just saying that, like, in movements that have had specific nonviolence clauses, a lot of times even defensive nonviolence, like when someone is getting their head bashed in by a cop and someone physically interferes in that officer physically harming someone, there have been nonviolent protesters who have effected citizens' arrests on people trying to defend other people.
Yeah.
And I think maybe just for the sake of discussion, one more point, and then we can come back to this discussion here in a couple minutes. Is that okay, everyone?
Just briefly, there may be some here who think that destruction of property is not violence, but that is not how the police will perceive it. If there is destruction of property, that will be construed as violence. And it will not, it won't just impact the people who are doing that, who are participating in that level of violence. It will affect the whole crowd. There will be mass arrest in all probability, and they will not distinguish between those who are lawfully protesting and those who decide to go another route.
Mic check.
Okay. While we get the sound fixed, we will return to mic check. So real quick, I would like to discuss a couple things a little further down the agenda. Before we move on to further discussion. Now, I think that everyone's been doing a very good job of this so far in keeping the speaking time to 3 to 5 minutes, but of course, through consensus operations and consensus decision-making, which we are using a modified 9/10 consensus, which means that 90% of those in attendance need to be okay with the decision that's being proposed for the group to adopt it as an official position now. Now, the nonviolence was adopted, and someone correct me if I'm wrong, but it was adopted at our last General Assembly meeting on Thursday, fairly overwhelmingly at that first General Assembly. Now, I should also make a note that that can change in the future. This is a fluid operation. All of the stances and viewpoints of Occupy Richmond are fluid, and they can always be proposed and changed at further General Assemblies. So, taking it to the next step, we also have some sign-up sheets going around right now for committee structure. Now, say that you are opposed to the non-violent nature of protest that has been, at this point, adopted by the General Assembly. Yes?
I'm really not okay with the idea of it being fluid that will move into violence. I came here, okay.
We're not doing anything wrong. Here we are, and our right to free speech and free assembly is protected by the first article of the Constitution. We're not thugs, we're not criminals, we're not anything like that. We're people who are using our lawful right and God-given right, I believe, to express ourselves. And I'm not here to hurt people or break stuff. You know, the last movement that we had 40 years ago, when people were doing the Civil Rights Act, what was really powerful were people in nonviolent, under extreme conditions. People were getting beat up, squirted with hoses, having their bones broken, but they stayed committed to nonviolence. Because when you deal with violence, that's what we're fighting. Yeah. We're fighting covert violence against us and overt violence against our property. We're the people being robbed. We don't have to rob people or hurt their property. We're not like them. We're different. And I think that's important.
Just want to say I'm totally with you, but your definition of what property destruction is and what's legal might differ from that of the police. I have been harassed by police for writing with sidewalk chalk outside of buildings downtown, and when I asked if what I was doing was vandalism, they responded, "It's not what you're doing it with, it's the message that you're writing." You know, so there's a slippery slope with all of this, and we have to be aware that anything that we do, even an occupation of what is constitutionally granted, can be manipulated by law enforcement and prosecuted as an illegal action where we're blocking traffic or we're someplace after hours, and we need to not allow these kind of bureaucratic constraints to affect our efficacy as a movement.
Okay.
Hi, my name is Yarrow. I'm hearing a lot of strong feelings on many sides of this. And I know that we can work this out because these are things that have been discussed with great passion by lots of folks for a long time. And for instance, up in DC, they have actions that are approved by their General Assembly, and they have autonomous actions. So that's one way things might go. I also think that talking to each other so that we know that putting my hand over my head so the police officer's club hits the hand is not violent. So I think we can work this out, and I think it's not going to be a simple statement.
Manny here. I would feel that going to the police, whatever you mean by going to the police, whether in a moment of confrontation or in the park or elsewhere, or going down to the police office, I wouldn't recommend that. I would just recommend that there's an organization called Legal Aid. They used to give out pamphlets, little white sheets of paper that anyone could just acquire from their office. And what it does is present it to the approaching policeman for a situation that you see as questionable of how they're treating a particular homeless individual. And they are obligated to put their badge number, their name on that piece of paper, and leave the individual alone. And if they don't do that, then you can have them brought before justice. And so I would just recommend that you go to Legal Aid and either have a town meeting with them, request it, or just request those pieces of paper, as well as get information regarding protesting what they regard as legal and illegal. That's just my suggestion.
Thank you so much. Is there anyone else who would like to speak on behalf of whether or not we are committed to nonviolent action and change? Yes, sir.
Hi, guys. My name's Jonathan. This is a position. I guess if I have to state a position, I can't side with the dogmatic avoidance of violence. Sometimes it is necessary. I just do ask the ones that might have a propensity to use it, to think about the effect it will have on the rest of the group, and only use it when absolutely necessary, if you're gonna deviate.
And I think form a people stack, so if you do have a response on this particular subject, maybe perhaps start a line right here. That way everyone who would like to speak has an opportunity to speak. So, sir.
Hi.
Hi, I'm Mark. I'd just like to say that this...
Close to the mic. Okay. I'd like to say, in New York City, the key thing that they're doing is occupying the square in a nonviolent manner, not giving the police the opportunity, so that when the police take the opportunity, it looks much worse for them. Yeah. Remember, your best defense is a video camera. It's one of your buddies, somebody across the street, getting the picture of the police officer violating your rights is very, very important. But at the same time, there is a line that everybody has to find when they say, no, I'm not going to do that. You know, many of the people out on the Brooklyn Bridge, they took the position that they would just sit there and wait. Others did. That's a personal choice you have to make at the time. My personal opinion, though, the bad publicity of a incident far outweighs the good publicity of a march. So I just strongly recommend everybody here, bring your video camera, keep it shooting, you know, watching moving around, watching what the other people are doing. And you can see beforehand, normally when the police are setting up to take an action. In Christiania, which is a city or a independent city in Copenhagen, they've been free for 30 years by a simple solution. When the police run in, they run out. When the police turn around and look back, everybody's back again. Okay? There's no problem whatsoever running away from a baton charge. Just don't leave the area. Move to the corners, move to the side. At some point, they will get tired. They will declare it Miller time and go home. We won't. Okay? That's the key here. We won't. This is an occupation. This is not politics. If you want politics, please vote next March or next spring, next fall. This is an occupation. Occupations don't happen on a political cycle. This is about getting the corrupting influence of the money from Wall Street out of the American government, period. Every other demand is a secondary subset by one portion or another, which may or may not have the may or may not actually be approved. I'm sorry?
We thought we weren't soapboxing today.
Good point. Valid point.
Well, I believe, and if anyone strongly disagrees, please please speak up, but I believe that this is probably an important point that would be very good for discussion right now. You know, we've got a lot of people here with a lot of ideas and a lot of opinions, so unless anyone's distinctly opposed to continuing discussion, I mean, we've got four people in line right here who'd like to speak, so. We adopted a 3 to 5 minute time limit for speakers, individual speakers, but this is, I mean, this is a very, very important point, and everyone seems fairly opinionated about it, so.
I would enjoy hearing this further.
No, please, at a certain point, I would love to.
Howdy. Okay, yeah, that's a good idea, too, but I'd like to state that it really doesn't hurt to be prepared. You can bring your helmets with you. You can bring things of that nature.
You're gonna bring water, you might as well bring protection. That's it.
You should have told people about like fingers and bandanas and shit like that.
In nonviolent,
that's a totally different like.
If 99% of the people are nonviolent, 1% are violent, what we're gonna hear about this is the 1%. I believe that if we're going to put a face forward, a face of peace, love, sharing, caring, tolerance, inclusiveness, that's the face that we want to put forward.
I would like to remind everyone that Gandhi and Dr. King were committed to nonviolence. And I would also like to say that this is a discussion and occupation about property and about wealth. We should not be violent over things. We should be violent over human rights or things like that.
Freedom.
But the point is, to be violent generally just takes away from our greater cause. And our cause is to end corruption. It is not a war. We are not soldiers. We are citizens exercising our rights. And our rights are not rights of violence.
Just to bring up a couple of points about the media presence and the importance of the media presence. We currently have a very strong and active media team that's all spread out throughout here. And we've already been placing things up on YouTube to develop our structure for the occupation. What we've come up with so far is that a standard media team will consist of four individuals: a primary videographer, a still photographer, somebody with an audio field recorder, and then a fourth person that I call God. And what God will do is film the people that are filming. So if God is forbid, the thugs and the badges and funny little hats and the guns start coming up and harassing us, we will have a perfect opportunity to have a perfect, unbiased, unedited record that will go up on the net immediately, and it's happening now. So in that regard, anybody that wants to get on board with the media team, put your name on a sign-up sheet or look for me, and I will make sure that by midnight tonight, if I haven't fallen asleep, I will get you on the Google group and on the mailing list, and expect to be put to work within 30 minutes after being put on that group.
Hey y'all, I personally think the People's Mic is an incredibly powerful tool. So if you don't mind, I'd like to use the People's Mic rather than the amplification system. Is that okay with everybody?
Yeah.
Okay, so,
Mic check!
Great. My name is Graham.
My name is Graham.
And one of the most powerful things about this movement that sets it apart from anything I've experienced before. Is the process we are in right now. Of listening to each other. Speaking our truth. Speaking our truth and then using those two tools, listening and speaking, to find consensus. Sorry, that was not very well said. But the tool of modified consensus. Of coming together around something by at least 90%. Shows that we have unity. And it shows that we can overcome conflict by talking, finding connection, and then using that connection to move forward. Together. This process right here. Fundamentally nonviolent.
Yes.
This is the only thing that we have done together. Is talk.
Listen.
And in small ways. Find consensus. We use that tool. To decide on a date. Of October 15th. And did so. By moving through conflict. To something we agreed upon together. I truly believe. This is the best way to move forward. In nonviolence. Listening and speaking. And finding modified consensus together.
Thank you.
Wow.
He picked it out of my brain. And out of my heart.
What we need
is what unifies us.
What we can agree on.
If I disagree with you. But I want to see success. I step outside of this group. And do what I need to do. But if we're going to succeed, we have to find the things that unite us. If we divide ourselves, they don't have to defeat us. We will defeat ourselves.
I couldn't have said it better.
I couldn't have said it better.
In the past two speakers.
In the past two speakers.
So I propose we move on. Because we have only addressed the first half of our itinerary. We have spent the past 40 minutes. Talking about the second item. Which in itself. Is going to be an ideological impasse. Many of the people here.
Myself included.
Will not be moved on that point. End story. Therefore, we must move on. To consolidate as a group. And act in unity. Therefore, let's move on to the work groups. Does anyone have a problem with this?
Can I say something before we move on?
Hi.
I'm Teddy Parham. And I don't want you to repeat after me, but I want you to listen to me. I'm into safety, and I want everybody to be safe. If you have asthma, bring your asthma medicine. If you have heart problems, bring your heart medicine. We're going to win this thing, but we won't win if any of you all get sick and take away. We need you. Prepare yourself. Get your things ready the night before. Don't wait until the last minute. We want this to be a success, unlike our government. So, we have to prepare to win, to run and win this race. And I just want to say, give thanks to the higher power in advance for us winning this war. Father, thank you. We just give thanks for the air that we breathe. We just give thanks for the sight we can see. Father, lead us, guide us, show us our enemies before they are upon us. Give us the strength to do what is right. Touch each of us in your own way. Let there be a smile within the group. Let there be love. Let there be less anger. Let's love one another. Let's talk to one another. We are one race, the human race, and together we can conquer all.
Mic check. I would like to remind everyone that consensus is a slow process.
At times, a very slow process.
We must be patient. We must persevere. So I propose. A modified consensus. Which is a nine-tenths vote.
In relation to
our nonviolence as a group. All those in favor of nonviolence. Please show your hands.
Point of process.
The group did consensus on this last week. And I hate to have every decision revisited without a proposal to change it. I heard a concern with nonviolence that I would be interested in having those folks come back and work out what their concerns are. And we've heard some specifics. But what I'm afraid of is that if we just take a vote without actually having
Last week we consensed on.
We are committed to nonviolent action and change. I don't believe there's been a proposal. To change that. If there was a proposal, I would suggest that we
I would suggest that we
follow it.
A few words at a time.
Yes, thanks.
It's an important enough issue.
It's an important enough issue.
That it needs almost a whole meeting. To review. If there was.
A concrete proposal.
To modify this commitment.
Modify this commitment.
Which so far we haven't heard.
I propose that we modify our consensus and maybe at another meeting talk about not having a nonviolence policy and instead embracing a policy of diversity of tactics. Proposal.
When do you suggest?
Saturday or Sunday?
Well, Saturday is after the occupation begins at like the first general assembly of the occupation.
I would propose that we use Saturday to get wherever we're going, and then when we're in place, talk about what we're interested in.
I think it'd be more legitimate general assembly.
It was passed through modified consensus at the last meeting, so we can revisit that.
On Saturday, we have to make sure we do not clash with the police forces. Doing that will only cause harm to our organization. Yes, we have to be sure that we do not cross paths with the police. They are on our side. They are part of the 99%.
They are not on our fucking side. That's correct.
But they don't make the money. They are on our side.
Work for the cops don't make the money. They're not on our side.
Everybody calm down. Mic check. I propose, as Mo just said, we meet in General Assembly, after the occupation begins, to continue this very important discussion,
on tactics.
Excellent. So, I believe that we have gotten through pretty much the first solid half of this agenda, so we should move next to the vote for ratification of Sober Space.